This is the Texas STAAR 2013 geometry test, and this is question number 9. It says line ZX and WY are secants of circle V, as shown below. Based on this information, which of the following can be proved true? Okay, let's try to understand this problem. Secants. What are secants? Well, those are lines that go through a circle that do not go through the center. So you can see the center is V. That's why it's called circle V. And they do not go through the center. They go through point U. And then I'm given the measure of the arcs. Oops, this arc and this arc, 60 degrees and 72 degrees. And that's it. Okay, so let's just read through these answer choices and see if we can eliminate any of them. So I understand I'm trying to find what's true with those secants and those arc lengths. My plan is to read the answer choices, see if I can eliminate some of them. Okay, so A says the measure of angle ZUY. So that would be this angle right here equals the measure of angle ZVY. So that would be this central angle here. Well, I think it's pretty clear that the central angle is going to be bigger than ZUY. So I'm going to rule that one out. Choice B says the measure of XUY. Let's mark that. XUY. That's this, equals half of arc WZ. Okay, that's one of the arcs that I was given. And arc XY. Okay, well yeah, I happen to remember that as being a property when you have intersecting secants, that as long as U, the point of intersection, is inside the triangle, then those two angles, this one and this one, are going to be equal to the average of those two arc lengths. So I'm pretty sure it's B. C. Says the measure of arc WX, so this one up here, is 180 minus the measure of arc WZ. Well, that looks like it might be true, but the problem is that this line here is not a diameter. It doesn't go through the center. You know, if we were talking about this line here, then yeah, we could say that, and say X, you know, was over here. Then we could say, yeah, we got two arcs that add up to 180 because it's a diameter. But that's not a diameter, so that's not going to work. And D says measure WUX. So let's find that. The angle WUX is equal to half of arc ZY minus WX. Well, that sounds like another relationship when we have these secants, but that's when their intersection is outside the circle. That's when we want to subtract the two measures of the arc lengths to find the angle. So that's not going to work for this case, because our intersection is inside. Okay, so as long as you remember that property of secants and circles, and you can keep straight whether the intersection is inside or outside the triangle. Inside, you're going to add the two arcs formed. Outside, you're going to subtract. Then you can know that the correct answer to this one is B. Okay, I hope that helps.